So much distance between us. Distance between our bodies. So much distance between us. Distance between our bodies. So much distance between us.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Abiola Solomon here. And if you're new to my channel, welcome, welcome, welcome. If you're interested in looking at this look today, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and stay tuned. Bye guys. Hey guys, so I already did one eye. I'm gonna go straight into the other eye. I'm gonna be using the Life as a Drag palette today, again. And I'm using my MAC 224 brush. Yes, I'm using it again, and I'm taking KK, which is that pink color, again. I'm just putting that in my crease. So remember, I pat and then swipe in. And I do that because I feel like it's easier to control the product. Okay. So that's all I put on my eye, just pat and swipe. And now I'm gonna go straight into my Morphe palette again. These are my two favorite palettes for color. And I'm gonna take that dark pink again. But I'm gonna change my brushes and I'm gonna use my crease brush that came with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Soft Glam palette and Mona Renaissance palette. Any palette that they have, it comes with a brush. And my crease, and I just go below and swipe in, pat and swipe in. I take the smaller brush. This is the Morphe 305 brush. I don't know if you guys can see, it's very small. And I take that right in my crease again, a little bit more down, so it looks more defined. And by the way, I'm taking the same color, the same dark pink in the Morphe palette. I'm taking the same color and just using a different brush. Now I'm gonna be cutting my crease. And I usually cut my crease with a white concealer, like a white concealer. I'm gonna show you on my hand. And you can get this white concealer from anywhere. I'm basically using a white concealer that I got from Seneca because I went to school for makeup, so they give you like extra stuff. That's basically a white adjuster, so I use that to cut my crease because it's the whitest concealer I have. And when I say white, I mean totally white. Don't get like a pink undertone concealer, get a white one. So it's your eyes pop out even more. I'm gonna go on with my MAC 242 brush. You know this is my favorite brush to cut my crease with. I like to turn that way so I can see my crease better. Like the outline of my crease better. And just follow that line. And to cut your crease, I would recommend to use really small strokes. That way you won't make a mistake. And now I'm gonna go in with my small angle brush. It's like a totally super small angle brush. It's like basically the smallest angle brush you can find. We'll do the trick. I like to use like a flat fluffy brush. When I say flat fluffy brush, I mean something like this. It's good to like blend out the whiteness from cutting your crease. Okay, so like so. So the next palette I'm going to go into is the Life as a Drag again. I'm going to be using Fishy and I'm going to be putting that all over my lid with my 242 brush from MAC.
Do
you guys see me looking this way, I have a mirror right in front of me, like a small mirror that I look at all the time when I do my eyeshadow, because it's really hard for me to look in the camera and do this. I don't know, it's kind of tricky for me, but I'll get the hang of it. Okay, so that's basically what I do. And then I use the Fenty Duo, what is it? The Kilowatt Foils. And I'm using Sandcastle and Mint Mojo. And this is how the palette, like, it looks. I'm gonna be using this light blue color, inner corner, sorry. Okay, so I'm done with the eye. I'm gonna go in with my NYX eyeliner, my vinyl, and I'm making a wing. And you see how I had the tape there, remember? The tape really helps to make that wing perfect. Like, so I went this way first, and now I'm gonna flick it this way to make it into a perfect wing. With my MAC 242 brush again, I'm taking Natural. It's the same color I used to prime my lid. Blend it out more with my finger. Like that. My favorite two palettes to highlight. So Glam is right here. And Funny Girl is right here. Okay, like that. Put on my lashes. I already put on one. These are the same lashes I used in my last video. I don't remember the brand of the lashes. It's just the name is Chloe. It's in a light pink package and it retails for $10. Just in case you never seen my last video. By the way, take a look at my last video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm gonna try and make videos more often, guys. Making hair glue. Regular hair glue comes with a red Taking a little bit on the back of a brush, just putting it right on my lashes. And I just place it in the area I want it to be, like so. Just place it there so it's tight, and then I squeeze it down. Starting off with my Pro Filter Primer from Fenty. So guys, a lot of people don't believe in primers. I used to be one of them, don't get me wrong. But I started using primers and you actually see a big, big difference in your makeup when you use primers. People tend to use primers and they'll be like, oh, this is not the one for me. I don't want to use this anymore. You know, da-da-da. I'm going to tell you guys a trick that I use that will help you with any primer you use. I'm about to show you this in my last video because I do this for every makeup. I do this for every makeup routine I have. I take my translucent powder, a sponge, and I put it in the areas that I want to mattify the most. That gets really oily throughout the day. You know what I mean? I put it in my nose area because that's where I get really oily. And I put on my laugh lines because I have a really strong laugh line. But you can even do that and just put it here. And put it here. Then I go in with my foundation, and today I'm using the Maybelline Superstay 24-hour. I don't know if you guys can see it. Yeah, 24-hour foundation for $15. Come on, like, it's a great foundation. See the coverage? Are you kidding me? And I'm done. I'm using the two LA Pro Girls concealers. One is in Pure Beige, and the other one is in Fawn. Mix it around, and I just use that as a highlight. I'm gonna go in with my contour. I usually use the Fenty Beauty Matchsticks and Espresso, which is the darkest shade, but today I'm using Mahogany. up with my e.l.f. stippling brush, which looks like this. To blend out my contour, just a fluffy brush, dome brush. It's not even a dome brush, but I usually use the Real Techniques brushes, like the purple one that I used in my last video. That's what I usually use, but I can't find it, so I'm just gonna use this brush. Then I'm gonna go straight into powder. As you guys know, I use a translucent powder from La Mercier, best powder. So I'm using the Film Noir with the R14 blending brush. Kind of dirty, but I don't know. I feel like when brushes are kind of dirty, they work better than it being clean. I know that's the stupidest thing anybody ever said in life. But when it comes to my contour brushes, I feel like, I really feel like that's the case. When it comes to like foundation brushes, no. But no, my contour brush, for sure. Like even the stippling brush, for sure. Not saying I don't clean it at all. I do, I just don't clean it as often as, you know, like foundation brush or other brushes, like my eyeshadow brushes. I'm gonna go into my Sun Power bronzer from MAC. Oh, by the way, I'm using the Bare Minerals But First Coffee blush. I use it because it has a red undertone. And I like blushes or stuff that has a red undertone because it still looks like bronzer. I don't even consider this a blush. I use it for bronzing. I am going to set my face with the MAC Mineralizer. And I'm gonna just set it with a normal sponge. Okay guys, so I'm going straight into highlight. I'm using the NYX Single eyeshadows in Golden Lust and Hypnotize. I'm gonna Golden Lust first, putting that on my nose. I'm going on my Cupid's bow. I'm going to go in with the Hypnotize. I'm going to go on my nose. Oops, that was a lot. Abby. And my nose bridge. And then I do those first and then I do my cheek last. And my forehead and my chin last. So I'm going with a Golden Lust again. This is the Anastasia Beverly Hills A23 highlighting brush, by the way. Going into Hypnotize. And then I go with my Fenty Beauty Trophy Wife. I use e.l.f. blush brush to highlight with Trophy Wife. I'm gonna use the same exact colors I used in my crease. I'm using that same Anastasia Beverly Hills, but I'm using the other side, the flat brush side, and I'm using that to go under my lash line. So that's all. Then I put mascara. Here's a trick to making your bottom lashes look more bigger, like more fuller. Mascara uses the Bad Gal Bang from Benefit. It's so good. I love it. I don't have no bottom lashes, so this helps a lot. Use any eyeliner, any black eyeliner, right? And put dots right, like everywhere on your lash line. Right in between your lashes. All the time. I tend to do this trick a lot. I'm using the NYX Lingerie lipstick collection in the shade Teddy. I'm gonna take the Kat Von D Locket Setting Spray. Put a lot on, shit.